Hi, I am Kavin from Carnegie Institute of Technology, URK20CS307. In this video, we are going to see about the usage of control statement for logical building. In this first question, to find the palindrome of a given number. Using class question 1, a public set voice string is a basic things for all the program. Int data type is used. We want to give an user input for, so we use a scanner function, and for if we give this scanner function, it will be import.java. It will scanner we want to use that package. Y is equal to x is equal to 0 while x is greater than or 0. Z is equal to x mod 10 and s is equal to s is multiplied by 10 plus z. X is equal to x divided by 10. If s is equal to y, system will be a given number is in palindrome. Else, the system is out dot print. If we there will be not a reverse number, is not a palindrome. If we run the program, we give 2332. It is a palindrome because if we reverse number 2332 only displayed. If we for not a palindrome number, we give 4432, it will be this not a palindrome number, because if we reverse that 234, it will be not palindrome number. Let's second question. To find the following pattern of an pyramid like structure by using the star function, and that they will be using a int data type nij scanner. We want to give an user input, so we using scanner function. In this we are using for loop, initialize condition and increment. I is equal to 0, I is greater than r, it will be increment, and j is equal to n, j is greater than I, it will be decrement. And in the loop, j is equal to 0, j is greater than I, it will be increment. If j is equal to 0, j is greater than I equal to I, j plus plus, it will be increment. Let's run the program and see. If we give 3, it will be print 3 rows, 1, 3, 5, it will be. The program is contained 1, 3 and 5, it will be displayed in this screen. The output is verified. The third program is to find the same pattern only, like palindrome 1 2 3 2 1. This program, this the scanner function to give an user input in rows, row by row we want to give an for loop. I is equal to 1, I is greater than or equal to rows, it will be decrement. For I is equal to j, j is equal to rows, j is greater than I, it will be decrement. For a int, int will be a number. K is equal to 1, k is greater than or equal to I, it will be increment. And L is equal to I minus 1, L is greater than or equal to I, L will be decrement. We run the program and see. This, if we give 3, will display 1 1 2 1 2 3 2. If I give 9, it will be print like this. You can see the pyramid like structure 1 1 2 1 1 3 2 2 1. The output is verified. In this to calculate the electricity bill for the given traffic, unit range to 1 to 100, it will be 1 rupees 0.5 paise. 101 to 300 unit range, it will be 2 rupees 35 paise. 301 to 500 unit range, 3 rupees 50 paise. If greater than or 500, 4 rupees 20 paise, we want to display. This float. Float is used for given point decimal numbers, there will be a scanner function to give an either user input while function is used. And if n is greater than 500, we want to multiply with 4.2 pi j. Else if the current is 300, the unit range will 300 above, it will be multiplied by 3.5 pi j. And if it be greater than 100, it will be displayed 2.35 pi j. Else if it will be multiplied by 1.05 pi j, and the total cost will be given a output. If you run the program, if I give 500.5, will be displayed 1277.1. If we give without 0.487 like that, it will be giving us a point number, because we are using a float value. So only it will be assigning a 1229.5. The output is verified. Next program, to develop a menu driven calculator with following operations: plus, minus, multiplication, division, and mod. In this, we are using the int data pipe and the scanner function to give a user input. And we're using a menu driven program. Enter your choice: addition, multiplication, subtraction, division, and exit. If the option is 5, we want to use a switch case, and these both are given the number by the user. In this case, first case is the addition. If this addition, if the operation, if we give one, the menu driven program addition, it will be give number 1 plus number 2. If we give subtraction, that number 1 minus 3. If the multiplication, number 1, number 2, multiply by. If the multi division will be number 2 is equal to 0, the in division denominator cannot be 0. The division and the quotient and the remainder will be mentioned. If we give above 5 in the menu driven program, it will be given invalid choice. Do you want to continue 1, yes or no? If we give yes, it will be again starting the menu driven program, and it will be displaying values. We'll run that program. In this, we give 1, it's 23 by 34. We give yes, it will display another time. If I give 23 and the invalid choice. If I give 23 or other numbers above 5, it will be given invalid choice. If you don't want to continue, give 2, no. It will be a given operator like this only. Okay, the program, the output is verified. Okay, thank you.